So hello everyone, this is Shayonti Talwar and welcome to all my dear TYBA compulsory English students. I am going to be dealing with half of your compulsory English syllabus and today's lecture is going to be an introductory lecture in which I plan to take you through the syllabus and through the relevance of the paper of compulsory English. So to start with, the text which you are going to study for your TYBA compulsory English paper is called Literary Pinnacles and it is an Orient Black Swan publication. Now this is the way the text has been divided. So the text has literature components which is comprised of prose and poetry. And then it has language components. Under language components, you have grammar, under which you have types of sentences. Then you have a section called Introduction to Communication Skills, which is all about how you can develop your communication skills, what are communication skills, and how do you go about using and enhancing your communication skills. Then you have presentation skills, and finally, you have soft skills. So we are going to be looking at each of these sections at length in the course of the lectures, right? So let's start with the relevance of prose and poetry. You might be majoring in different subjects like history, geography, psychology, political science, or maybe some language like Hindi or Marathi. And you might be wondering why this paper called compulsory English? What is the relevance of a paper like compulsory English? So, primarily compulsory English, like I said, a major section of this paper is literature. What does literature do? Literature basically deals with universal themes that are common to all human beings, that all human beings can relate to and identify with. For example, the theme of falling in love, the theme of right and wrong, or the theme of betrayal, or the theme of friendship, or the theme of a struggle, right? Or the theme of facing a problem. So here, the problem may be different. I might be looking at a character's problem in a story. And I may have a problem in my life. So the context could be different. The problems could be different. But what remains common is the fact that both of us have to face the same problem and we have to come up with a solution. So in this manner, literature actually makes us realize that life is not so different, right? I mean, I could be sitting here in India, in the state of Maharashtra, and I could be reading about someone who is sitting in England or in Australia, or maybe it could be the story of a person 100 years ago, and still there would be some commonalities in their life and in my life. So that is what literature is all about, universal themes, right? And in the process, what happens is when we are exposed to these universal themes, we start developing empathy, compassion, and we start becoming more and more sensitive to people, their problems, their miseries, their hardships, and we also start relating more and more with their successes, with their failures, with their predicaments, and with their situations,